Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and thank you for watching the other videos and this series about to how we can prepare our lab environment. So in my the first video you seen how we can install SQL 2K12 in our virtual machine VMware, and the second video was like how you can configure your IP address and how you can change your the RAM. So if you want this video, so you can go back and watch that video. So going further, it will be like a very helpful to build your lab. So in this video I will show you in the Active Directory how we can create the group and the users, so which is gonna help you to log in the other machine and about there the rights. So let me start this video. I can type the window and press the window button and type the Active Directory, ACTIVE Active Directory, user and computers. We have to go here. Okay, so this screen is open and I can tell you the shortcut as well. Type the run command, open the run command and type dsa.msc. Open this, msc. So you will open the same window what we opened like the Active Directory. Okay, so here is the screen. You can see in the by default users are here, computers are here. So in the computer, if you added any of the computer in the domain, first it will reflect here and then you can move it to any other group. So DC, you can check your domain controller here, as I have installed DC domain controller here in the my domain controller. Sorry, in the lab machine, so automatically it reported to the domain controller group. Okay, so let's talk about the groups. So here, how we can create the username. So right click on users, click to the new, and here is a user. So here you can click it, and here you can create any of the account, like the I'm building the lab for my SCCM. Can give the SCCM first name or last name, whatever you want to give it, and the logon as a SCCM. So now I will click on next, and you must change the password on the next logon. If you are in the production and you are creating a user to some other guy, so you need to select this and put your temporary password, so and send it to the user. So what will happen when the user will log in and it will ask for the change the password. Okay, so but I don't want to change this password. I want to keep it like the user cannot change the so I can put it like a password never expire, because I'm going to use as a service account, and the service account password should not be expired, or else it will be causing an issue in your production. So let me put the password here, and it's like something. Okay, next. So this my user is created, but this user is not having any rights. Even if this account you will use to log in, we unable to log in, I will show you the how you will do it. So I am just going to log off this machine, log off, and here control and delete, and I'm going to use my SCCM account with the password. So what error will get? So sign method you are trying is not allowed. For the more information, contact your network administrator, because my the SCCM account is not having any rights of login or any of the machines. So let's see how we can give the rights here. Let me log in this, and now go to here and type the dsa.msc. And I am going to assign like a domain user. If I assign the rights as a domain user, I can add it here. So it will be like a normal domain users. And if it is I am going to assign like a domain admins, so it will be automatically part of the administrator. So let's see, click on this, user taken, and now it's created. So now my machine is the domain admin. So So whenever you are building the lab, your account should be as a domain admin. Okay, if you want to create like an enterprise admin or the schema admin, you are going to modify anything under the schema. Okay, you can do it. But for the SCCM, yes, you should be the schema admin as well, because you are gonna extend the schema in the Active Directory. So let me click here and add it here. Now other rights are not needed, and let me show whether we can able to log in or not. Okay, so now I'm going to use my SCCM account to log in it. Okay, yes, I'm able to log in. So now I log in this machine with my the SCCM account. So my 3-4 part is done. In my past videos, like how we can install server in the VM. Second part is like how can I assign the IP address and changing the host name. So that part is done. And then how we can install the Active Directory, that part is done. And in this video, you seen it how you can create an account for your lab and how you're gonna give the rights for it. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. And the next video will be like how we can install the prerequisite to install your SCCM. So there is a prerequisite like SQL. So SQL installation is already I showed you in my the last videos. You can find out easily in my SCCM playlist. So how you can install it. So I will be on the next video like the prerequisite for SCCM. Okay, not for the SQL database. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.